Happy Halloween, mon petit chiffre. Amber here. Welcome, actually, to my November vlog, my November NaNoWriMo vlog. November is about to start, which means that I am dedicating the whole month to, please God, finishing this novel. And I wanted to start now because it's Halloween. I have my hat on. 4946 Cypress Pond. Let's do this. And we're back. Let me intro this properly. Good morning. It is 9:28 a.m. on November 1st, which means it's the first day of... This is so out of focus for some reason. Hello? Okay, anyway, so it's the first day of NaNoWriMo. And even if I'm not doing it in the traditional sense, I'm going to keep calling it NaNoWriMo because that stands for National Novel Writing Month. And I am taking November to finish writing this novel. So, I'm sat down. I've got a little office of supplies. Ooh. Got my ice water, got my iced coffee, and the most exciting development, or I wanted it to be the most exciting development, even though I'm not using them right now because I still have to set them up and pair them with my phone and stuff. I have a new pair of headphones. Got some noise canceling headphones because ideally I would be secluded somewhere. Finishing this. I mean, I am secluded somewhere. I'm at home during a global pandemic, so, but I've also been in the same place for 7 months. So I'm gonna hopefully have those to fully block out. Actually, before I get started, let's do this part. Okay. Go on this journey with me. I wanna focus on... Hey Mom, hey Meg. We're deleting Twitter. Did I do it? Oh, sorry. And we're deleting Facebook off my phone because I don't need those distractions. That's what they are. Okay, so the game plan for right now, the starting out point, is basically where I left off in my last writing vlog. If you watch those, then you know what I was working on and then just kind of stopped. I have this little stack of plot cards to finish going through and organizing or getting rid of if need be. So that's what I need to do first before I try to accomplish anything else. Welcome to NaNoWriMo. Pray for me. Second day of NaNoWriMo. There's my mom. Why the mask, you ask? Well, this is what happens when someone in your house decides to put everyone at risk. So we're wearing these for 2 weeks just in case. Anyway, I'm trying to figure out what today's game plan is because I could just sit and stare at misplaced plot cards all day, but then like nothing's gonna get done. So what I'm thinking of doing is taking like one or two, at least starting with one or two of my boards from my last writing blogs, and going through the file on Scrivener and everything that I organized on the board, making sure it's organized in the file. Cool. Good. What time is it? Afternoon. It's 1:03. And this is the first day that I'm actually setting up to write in 2 days. I've been just not wanting to do any work.
Sorry, it's 12:18. The channel is 1:03.
It's 12:18. And yeah, I just haven't felt motivated to write in the past 2 days with all the election stuff. Still hasn't been called. Pennsylvania, please don't let me down. Anywho, but I'm sitting down to write a couple things. I walked in from a nice refreshing shower and my mom set up this cute little writing space. How adorable. All my kids there for support. I'm gonna get started. I've got my brand new onesie on. It finally came, you know, tradition. It's Marie from the Aristocats. Usually I get a new onesie when I'm starting a new project, but we're trying to finish. I feel like this is important enough, you know? And she matches my brand new headphones. I'll show you when I sit down. But I really thought it was 1:03. Good afternoon. It was morning a minute ago. Today is the 6th. It's day 3 of the election. I am crusty. Oh my god. Okay, we're going to talk like this. I woke up this morning, 9 o'clock, as I do. I was like, maybe I'll catch a few more minutes. And then I got on Twitter and saw that both Georgia and Pennsylvania have gone blue and won. I'm so proud of my state and specifically my city. I need to get something done today, but I don't know. I don't want to get hopeful. I really don't. Good morning. Today is November 13th. Is that today? Yes. November 13th, and I haven't done anything with this novel since whenever the last clip was. What did you say? Today is Friday the 13th. That's exciting. Anyway, so since whenever the last clip of this is, I just haven't felt like it. Between all the election news and updates and this weather, it's impossible to focus on anything else. Pair that with the fact that I'm already at the place where I'm like, I have nothing else for this novel. My brain's gone full slump mode. Not just with writing. I've been struggling to read. I've been struggling to really do anything. But I woke up today. I won't say early, because it's 11:43 right now. The initial plan was to wake up at 9, but like I said, this weather, it's been raining. I feel like it's been raining for like 2 weeks straight, but I feel like that's not accurate. Is that saying? Oh, so the plan was to get up at like 9. That didn't happen. So it's 11:43 now. I don't know what I'm going to get done, but since the last clip, I have reorganized the file, I guess, in Scrivener, where when I was working with the boards, I put the scenes that I had reorganized in the order that they need to be in now. So ideally, that gives me a clue, or it should make it easier to fill in what needs to be filled in. I'm not saying it will make it easier, because my brain's like crickets, but it should. So I'm never gonna finish this thing. This is very close. Can I unzoom that? Thank you so much. Hi, important update. I haven't done a writing update for this vlog. Let's try that without, use your words. I haven't done an update for this vlog in I don't know how long, because who wants to really see clips of me, a bunch of clips of me just reading through the manuscript, but this here notebook right here has been at my aunt's house for like 2 years, and I just got it back today, like maybe an hour or so ago. This here notebook contains all of my original notes and plans from when I first started working on this novel back in 2017. Oh my god, 17? Yeah. Oh. So I'm so excited. I haven't looked in it yet. I don't know what's in here. But I don't know, that just gives me a little pep, a little buzz. With like 10, 11 days left of the month. But yay! Good morning, good afternoon, whatever. I'm popping in because I had a revelation. So yesterday, the day before yesterday, I spent most of my day listening to the Prince of Egypt soundtrack. Yes, this is important to the story. And one, how did I forget that The Plagues is the bop of all bops? What? Especially with my noise-canceling headphones. So, I'm listening to that, right, on repeat. Initially I listened to it like 4 times in a row. Listening to it on repeat, and then I'm sitting here like, wow, is it too late to make this story a Prince of Egypt retelling? Because I'm noticing that there are a lot of elements to it that are similar to the Prince, I say the Prince of Egypt, like, the Prince of Egypt specifically, not necessarily, yeah, I guess the whole Moses Exodus story, but I prefer the Prince of Egypt version of the story. There's music. But anyway, I was sitting here and then I realized, upon this babbling and replaying The Plagues, because it really, if you haven't listen to it in a while, listen to it. I mean, the whole soundtrack is magnificent and Disney could never, but that with just some really good headphones. Anywho, it's the overlapping vocals. Anyway, I figured out the villain of this whole story. That's been one thing that's been holding me back this whole time. I know who the villain is. but I didn't, there's like still so much that I didn't understand about them, like why they do the things that they do, what motivates them. And I think I'm finally having a breakthrough, and that I at least have figured out what caused them to do the thing. So that's at least a starting point. That's at least a place I didn't think I'd get to. And now I wrote it down in my little no problema notebook. But now I gotta figure out how to properly insert it into what I have. But that's exciting. So I might actually get some work done today. With what, 6 days left of the month? Better late than never. Hello. It's no longer November. It's March. It's actually March 27th, and finally getting entirely too warm to wear this hat, but I haven't worn it in a video, so hello. So, as you can see, I didn't finish the novel. I didn't finish the draft. And if I'm being honest, at this point, I don't know what I'm going to. I say this as we approach the start of Camp NaNoWriMo, and I'm debating if I'm going to take April to work on. I don't think I'm going to work on this project. If anything, I might work on one of the other ones to try to get more actually solidified with those. But as far as this project goes, are we tired of seeing vlogs where I claim I'm going to get a bunch of work done and or finish it, and then I don't, and then I complain about it? Because I think I'm tired of this pattern. I'm trying to remind myself that it's okay to not be creative, because we are in unprecedented times in a global pandemic. We are not, you know, doing the things that stimulated us as we used to. But I was kind of done before Rona. So I don't know. I'm feeling frustrated and irritated, and I'm not quite sure how to fix this and redirect it back to something that could work. But here's a vlog. Thank you for watching it if you did. If you like this vlog or videos like this, please give this a thumbs up. If you like me, feel free to subscribe. All my places are down below, so you can follow me, and I'll follow you back. And I'll see you very soon. Bye.